In this video, we're going to go over how to write the equation of a line if you know two points on the line. In previous videos, we figured out how to write the equation of the line if we knew the slope and one point. So in this situation, we know two points on the line. There are two methods I'm going to cover. The first method is to simply graph the two points and draw the line. Now you have to be very careful and accurate if you're going to use this method. And if it's easy to determine the slope by visually looking at your graph and to determine the y-intercept, you can directly substitute the values for m and b into the equation y equals mx plus b. So here's an example. Write the equation of the line passing through negative 2, 1, and 2, negative 5. So let's do this graphically. Let's simply plot those two points and see if we can tell what the slope and the y-intercept is. All right, so we've got to plot negative 2, 1. So we go negative 2, 1 will be right here. And then we've got to do 2, negative 5, which will be right here. And then you very carefully have to graph the line going through those two points. All right, so I've done a graph of this. I don't have a straight ruler, but it looks to me like the y-intercept is at 0, negative 2. So it looks like b is negative 2. And for the slope, we can just count the spaces here. Starting up here at negative 2, 1, I can go over to the right four spaces. So we're going over four spaces. And then I am going to go down, how many spaces? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spaces. So I'm going down 6. And if I just simplify that, I have -3/2. So by visually graphing those two points, it looks like the equation of the line is y equals the slope, -3/2, x minus 2. All right. So if you're extremely accurate, and you'd prefer to get out graph paper and figure out the equation that way, you can do that. Now, the other way to figure out the slope between those two points, as opposed to just counting the spaces here, would be to use the slope formula. So let's do it that way as well. Make sure we really do get -3/2. So we take one ordered pair and put the y over the x. We'll put the 1 over the -2. And then we'll take the other ordered pair and we will put the y over the x, which will be -5/2. And that gives me 6/-4, which does reduce to -3/2. So I could just verify also algebraically that the slope is -3/2. So that's the first method. You can graph it and figure it out that way. The second method is a more algebraic way of doing it without getting out graph paper. You can use the formula for slope to determine the slope of the line, which we just did in the first method as a little check. And then you can use the slope point formula using that slope and one of the points that you're given to find the equation. Or you could also do the other method where you plug in an ordered pair, x and y, and the slope in and solve for b. So here's the same problem we just did. We're going to use method 2. So I need to determine the slope. We actually just did this, but I'll just do it again. We're going to take one ordered pair and put the y over the x, and the other ordered pair y over x. And it doesn't really matter which ordered pair you put before the minus sign and which one's after. So that's going to be 1 - -5 = 6. -2 - 2 = -4. Don't write 0. Because that's -2 + -2, and that's just -3/2. So now I know the slope is -3/2. Now, to use the slope point formula, I just need to use one of those ordered pairs. It doesn't matter which one. So let's choose -2, 1. We'll do this again using the other ordered pair and see that you would get exactly the same equation. All right, now we're going to use the point slope formula, which remember is y - y1 = the slope, remember your parentheses, x - x1, and we are going to put in -3/2 for the slope, And for the ordered pair, let's see, negative 2 is your x1, so we're going to put in negative 2 for your x1 coordinate, and we're going to put in 1 for your y1. So this gives me y minus 1 equals the slope, which is negative 3 halves, times x minus negative 2. So x minus negative 2, remember, will be x plus 2. And now we can solve for y if we want to put this in slope-intercept form. So y minus 1 equals, we're going to have to do the distributive property, negative 3 halves x, and I have to distribute my negative 3 halves to the 2 as well. So that is going to be minus, now the 2's are going to cancel, so it's going to be minus 3. Then we'll just add 1 to both sides, and we'll get y equals negative 3 halves x minus 2. And there's the equation of the line in slope-intercept form. Now, is that what we got when we did it the previous method? Let's go back up and check. Here's the same problem using method 1. Remember, we graphed it, and we also got y equals negative 3 halves x minus 2. Let's do method 2 using the other ordered pair, 2, negative 5. So the original problem, we were given the points negative 1, 2, and 2, negative 5, and we've already figured out more than once that the slope was negative 3 halves, so I'm not going to show you how we came up with that again. And now we're going to use the point slope formula again, but we will plug in the other ordered pair, because it doesn't really matter which one you plug in. All right, so if I'm going to plug in the ordered pair, I'm going to use the ordered pair 2, negative 5 this time. I'm going to put in 2 for my x1, and I'm going to plug in negative 5 for my y1, and I'm still going to use negative 3 halves for my m. So that gives me y minus negative 5 is plus 5 equals the slope, which is negative 3 halves, x minus 2. And now if we want to solve for y, I'm going to subtract 5 from the other side at the same time that I do my distributive property here. I have negative 3 halves x. Now, negative 3 halves times negative 2 will be plus 3, because the minus signs cancel, the 2's cancel, and I'm going to subtract 5 from both sides, so I have minus 5. So check it out. Again, I get y equals negative 3 halves x minus 2. Now, I've put these in slope-intercept form, but of course, you could have done this problem by putting it in standard form, either after you put it in slope-intercept form by multiplying both sides by 2 and then putting the x term on the other side. Let's do that as a little review. I could take this equation, multiply both sides by 2, so I have 2 times y and 2 times negative 3 halves x minus 2. So I get 2y equals, now I'm going to distribute that to negative 3x minus 4, or 3x plus 2y equals negative 4. That is the line in standard form. Now the last thing we want to do is make sure that I did get the correct equation of the line. I haven't done any checks using method 1, method 2, using either of the ordered pairs. So let's go back to the original problem. So our original problem was to write the equation of the line passing through negative 2, 1, and 2, negative 5. And we did this problem three different ways, and when we put it in slope-intercept form, we got y equals negative 3 halves x minus 2. When we put it in standard form, we got 3x plus 2y equals negative 4. We want to make sure that both of our original ordered pairs work in either of these equations. So let's go ahead and plug it into the standard form. I'm going to first check negative 2, 1. So we're going to put in negative 2 for x, 1 for y, and make sure that's a true statement. That says negative 6 plus 2 is negative 4. Excellent. And now let's go ahead and check 2, negative 5 to make sure that also works in that equation. So we have 3 times 2 plus 2 times negative 5 is 4. So that 6 minus 10, oops, is negative 4, also checks. And I'll leave it to you to go ahead and put those ordered pairs in. If you had done it in slope-intercept form, they will also check. But make sure you check both ordered pairs, because there's a lot of lines that go through negative 2, 1, and a lot of other lines that go through 2, negative 5. We want the one line that goes through both of those two ordered pairs.